procedure for endoscopic pyloric duodenal stent placement. This presentation illustrates endoscopic placement. Gastric outlet and duodenal obstruction is most commonly caused by pancreatic or gastric carcinoma or metastases to the upper retroperitoneum. Aegis stents provide rapid and lasting relief of gastroduodenal obstruction. There are four types of Aegis pyloric stents. The most popular stent is the double bear Aegis due to its excellent conformability and resistance to migration. If a covered stent is used, the possible future need for ERCP and access to the papilla needs to be considered. Tubular gold markers on a stent increase radiopacity and visibility on fluoroscopy. A hydrophilic guide wire is recommended for crossing the stricture, but a stiffer wire is required for stent placement. Combination wires with a stiff shaft and a hydrophilic tip avoid the need for wire exchanges. If a duodenoscope is used, long ERCP wires are required. A sufficiently long catheter, ideally an ERCP catheter, is required. A sphincterotome allows additional directional control over the guide wire. An endoscope is passed through the stomach to the proximal end of the structure. A therapeutic endoscope with a large working is preferable, as it allows stent placement through this. A catheter is inserted through the working channel. Injection of a contrast medium outlines the position and length of the stricture. The stricture is crossed with the help of a hydrophilic guide. The wire may be used to gauge the length of a stricture. A hydrophilic wire needs to be exchanged for a stiffer 0.035-inch wire unless a combination nitinol wire is used. The stent delivery system is advanced over an ERCP wire through the stricture, ideally through the large working channel. The stent is positioned across the tumor and should extend 1 to 2 centimeters beyond both ends of the stricture. The sheath is unlocked and withdrawn while stent position is confirmed under fluoroscopic control. Most stents will not expand fully straight away, as the shape memory is activated on warming to body temperature. Stents will continue to expand over several days, and balloon dilation is not usually required. Your local S&G Biotech representative will be more than happy to answer any questions and provide assistance if required. Thank you.